Good evening, doctors. Myself, Ruchita from FDC, welcome you all for the 9th very important session of Diabetic Essential by very respected Padma Shri Dr. K.K. Agrawal sir. And before handovering the session, I would like to announce last week winners. And the names are Dr. S. Pandey sir, from Korba, Chhattisgarh, Dr. Bimla Kapoor from Delhi, Dr. Gautam Dutt from Ranchi, Jharkhand, Dr. Damodar Jaiswani from Nagpur, Dr. Beena Gesota from Mumbai, Dr. Girish Gesota from Mumbai, Dr. Dharmika Tandon from Mumbai, Dr. Anupama, Dr. Harsh Shah, Mumbai, Dr. Kulbhushan Tandon, Mumbai, Dr. Hemant Adkane from Powai, Mumbai, Dr. Neelam Mehta from Mumbai, Dr. Jagruti Dhaburwala from Mumbai, Kirit Lalan from Mumbai, Sushma Wale from Chinchwad, Dr. Bhavini Gala from Mumbai. Few more names are there. Dr. Manju Vasudev from Navi Mumbai, Dr. Dakshyani Menon from Mumbai, Dr. Suman Agrawal, Mumbai, Dr. Nariman Doctor, Dr. Saroj Narang from Mumbai, Dr. Seema Shah, Dr. Shashikant Shende, Dr. Kamar Menon, Dr. Jayashree Salian, Dr. Vinita Shetty, Dr. Vilas Sonavne and Dr. Sudhir Jain, Dr. Sanjay Manotra, Dr. Arun Kumar Garg, Dr. Ashwini Kumar, Dr. Shantanu and Dr. Souvik Mandal from Kolkata. We congratulate to you all and I would like to hand over this session to Dr. Agrawal sir. Welcome sir.
Thank you, Ruchita. Thank you, FDC, for this series of essentials of diabetes. 52 weeks with Dr. K.K. Agrawal and 9th in a row. Let's start with a meeting with since morning, if you are talking, this is my 11th episode since morning. And Vedic science says that before each episode, if you drink zero caloric fluid, it builds up your stamina, it builds up your pranavayu, and it builds up your capacity to speak. That's what I took. Energizal Zero, which I do it as a routine whenever I speak. So the topic today is day one. Last time we talked about day zero. Today we are talking about day one. What's the difference? Day zero, you have now confirmed the diabetes. You have listened to the patient. On day zero, the patient is not ready for the counseling, because he comes for a shock. Oh my God, I have developed a diabetes. Whatever you tell him, he may not be in a state of mind to understand. So therefore, day one, day zero is the day of diagnosis. Day one is when he's ready to listen to you. Day one is a day of counseling. In Bhagavad Gita, it is equivalent to chapter 2, which is the longest chapter of Bhagavad Gita. Day zero is just listen to the patient. Day one is counseling, counseling, and counseling. So day zero belongs to the doctor and day one belongs to the patient. He wants to know all types of answers. Let's talk about what counseling needs to be done on day one. So this is Diabetes Essentials. 52 weeks with Dr. K.K. Agrawal, which can be given as a gift to your colleagues. And the topic is day one of diabetes in patient with type 2 diabetes. Now the diagnosis is confirmed. Now the patient has come for a lifestyle consultation. What should I eat? Should I stop the smoking? What medication should I take? Can I continue my alcohol? Will I be able to enjoy my sexual life? Will I continue my driving? And what not? These are a couple of points which comes in his or her mind. He would like to know, can I eat wheat? Can I eat rice? Can I eat maida? Can I eat suji? If I want to eat rice, which rice should I take? Normally, we say 50% of your diet should be carbohydrate. And we avoid all types of refined carbohydrates with high glycemic food index. Chini, chawal, maida, we like to avoid. If they are wheat sensitive, we will avoid wheat in them. Bajra, jowar, makki, ragi, all things we can give. So first of all, we will like to avoid them. Refined high glycemic foods. Proteins, yes, we will like to give them a good protein diet. The reason being, most of them may have sarcopenia because of muscle weakness, because of insulin resistance. So we will give them a good protein, minimum 1 gram per kg body weight. But definitely we will avoid a red meat into them, which is inflammatory diet. Fats, yes, we will give them a mix of the fats. We'll say ghee, tel, makhan, 1/2 kilo per person per month. We say zero trans fat. And we say go on changing the oil. Go on changing the oil. And we will like to avoid reuse of oil and oxidation of oils. By this time, we know this patient is pro-inflammatory and pro-thrombotic. So therefore, rancid oils, reheating, we will avoid. We will build him up on a regular exercise. We say your regular exercise. Not to smoke, consume alcohol in limitation. That is required to reduce all types of micro and macrovascular disease. Remember, multifactorial risk factor reduction in diabetes reduces mortality. So we say manage the ABC, A for A1C for diabetes, B for blood pressure, and C for LDL cholesterol. In susceptible individuals, we will add aspirin if their risk of heart attack in the next 10 years is more than 10%. Now, many of the women of childbearing age, on the very first day, will start talking about, can I become pregnant? I'm talking about diabetes in 30s. Today, women are getting married at the age of 30. And immediately they say, oh my God, they have just got married and you are telling me I'm having diabetes. How will I be able to plan my pregnancy? What contraception I need? Remember, tight glycemic control is required if you are planning for pregnancy. Proper counseling is important. Healthy pregnancy requires virtually normal levels of sugar, and proper contraception is required if they are not planning for pregnancy. Then the person will start asking on the very first day, am I likely to get a heart attack? Will I develop a stroke? Will I develop my gangrene? Do I need aspirin? So if the risk is more than 10% in 10 years, yes, they need aspirin. They start asking, do I need a statin? Everybody knows diabetes means that it is presumed to be coronary artery disease. So he would like to know, do I need a statin? The answer is Yes, if the person is over 40 years of age and LDL is on the higher side, he needs a statin. He may need a medicine like fibrate if the triglycerides are high and HDL is low. He will say, will I need a colchicine? If the CRP is more than one, the patient may require a colchicine, as specifically if he has an underlying stable coronary artery disease. This is a up-to-date recommendation which comes very clearly based on the trial called LODOCO 2 trial, low dose colchicine 2 trial, which talks about that colchicine is required if you have underlying stable coronary artery disease and if your CRP is more than one. So how do I remember what to do in a patient of diabetes? Remember the word 80, 80. Fasting sugar less than 80, lower blood pressure less than 80, LDL cholesterol less than 80, abdominal circumference in female less than 80, heart rate less than 80, HDL more than 40 or half of 80, triglyceride less than 160, which is double of 80. If fasting sugar is between 80 and 160, that means 80 to 80 into 2, one medication, 80 to 80 into 3, two medication, 80 into more than 240, three medication, and more than 340, 320, that means 80-80 into 4, you require insulin. These are the formulas you can remember. Another formula you can remember on day one as a doctor, that if my patient has a HbA1c very, 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 very high, how do I calculate my insulin? 0.3 units per kg body weight, double it in a moderate case, for obesity, triple it. But remember the word 3, 0.3, 0.6, 0.9. Then increase it by 3 units every day. Do A1C every 3 months. Start insulin if 3 drugs fail. Remember the word formula of 3 when the patient is there on day 1. Remember 2 formulas, give it to the patient. The formula of 1,500 and the formula of 500 in insulin. Divide 1500 with the total daily insulin dose called TDD, and it will give the change in blood sugar levels with 1 unit of insulin. So therefore, you can calculate each unit of insulin, how much blood sugar will come up and down. And the formula of 500, divide 500 with total daily dose of insulin, and it will give the grams of carbohydrate required to neutralize 1 unit of insulin. This slide, make a print screen, this will help you. Now we come back, the patient will say, you ask the patient, do you have an erectile dysfunction? He says, not at the moment. We have discussed last time how to detect. But tell these patients that if you are not going to manage your diabetes very well, you may end up into an erectile dysfunction. Caution them. Aadmi na mardi aur aurte badsurti ko kabhi nahi chahti. Agar kisi aurat ko bol do ki cigarette peene se jhurriya aa jayengi chehre pe to chhod degi. Aur aadmi ko bol do ki tum na mard ho jaoge to wo chhod dega. So therefore, all men with diabetes on day one should be told, arre bhai, agar aapne diabetes properly control nahi kare, you will not be able to enjoy the normal sex. Diabetes and driving. Now he is going to ask on day one, should I drive? Should I go back or should I call my driver? Now there are clear-cut guidelines which require safe driving, and the risk is hypoglycemia. Hypoglycemia, always carry a blood glucose meter in a vehicle and stop if you get hypoglycemia and the alert value is less than 70. If your sugar is less than 70 milligram per deciliter, you will be able to drive, but you are more accident prone because intellectually it will impair your judgmental power. Therefore, American Thoracic Society says, uncontrolled diabetes, no driving. Low blood sugar, no driving. Insulin or tablets of diabetes, except metformin, be careful. Blood sugar more than 300, no diabetes. Patient with insulin dependent diabetes, no commercial driving. Always carry meals and snacks with you when you are driving. It is safest not to delay meal times. Always eat in time. Take regular short breaks while driving. Do not delay treatment of low blood sugar. Be aware of warning signals. Remember, car ko push karte hue bhi sugar kam ho sakta hai. Normally, as a driver, if there is a puncture, you will get down and you will change the tire. And if your blood sugar is 80, it can suddenly become 70 and you may not be fit to drive. The best advice is to drive. Do not drive if you are a diabetic after drinking alcohol. Wait for at least 12 hours for the alcohol to be broken down before driving. 1 to 2 hours. End of life care. If you have somebody who is sick, diagnosed diabetic for the first time, then treat him like any other end of care. New onset diabetes. The new onset diabetes means you have a COVID-19 and you are detected to be new onset diabetes. In COVID-19, there are two types of diabetes you are seeing. Existing diabetes getting precipitated and a new onset diabetes, which may disappear or which may become permanent diabetes. It's something like stress-induced diabetes. This is called COVID diabetes. Physical activity. How much physical activity should I do? 150 minutes per week, 30 minutes of moderate intensity aerobic activity each day, 15 to 30 minutes of work-related activity, and 15 minutes of muscle strengthening exercise. I normally say, hafte mein do din walk karo, hafte mein do din cycling karo, aur hafte mein do din muscle strengthening karo. I always tell all my doctors, for 52 weeks, if you watch this program every Sunday at 9 p.m., for half an hour, your diabetes may disappear. Kaise? Provided you are sitting on a cycle and watching and drinking Energal Zero. That means you are not taking any caloric food. You are taking Energal Zero, which is caloric free, watching our program every Sunday from 9 to 9:30 on a cycle. Hafte mein ek din bhi cycling karte ho. Exercise induced. Oh my God, this is my slides are not being seen. So exercise induced hypoglycemia. Remember, if you are exercising and your blood sugar becomes less than 90, I am worried. To reduce post-exercise hypoglycemia, add carbohydrate 1 gram per kg per hour. Tell the patient, that you need to buy a glucometer and self-monitor your blood glucose. So behavioral lifestyle intervention will further add to intake of salt, which should be reduced. Intake of alcohol, which should be moderated. Now tell them on the very first day, you need a hepatitis B vaccine if not taken, tetanus and diphtheria vaccine if not taken, herpes zoster vaccine if not taken, COVID-19 vaccine if not taken, flu vaccine every year, and pneumococcal vaccine, two vaccines at PCV 13 now and PPSV 23 1 year later. Then when we are starting them on oral antibiotic agents, we will consider whether the patient has nephropathy or not. If the patient has nephropathy, we will start with SGLT2 inhibitor. If he has obesity, we will start with metformin. If he has very high insulin resistance, we will start pioglitazone. If the patient has atherosclerosis, SGLT2 inhibitor. If the patient has increased risk of hypoglycemia, then we will start a gliptin. And if the patient has a very high sugar, we will start a glimepiride group of drugs. Then the patient will say, I need to build up my immunity. Do I need some supplements? Yes, chromium, magnesium, vitamin D, methi, curcumin extract. Curcumin, you can give it in haldi. Methi, you can give it in the sabzi. Vitamin D supplementation is a must, 1,000 units every month. Magnesium and chromium supplements are available. Otherwise, all sprouts contains these types of. Now, coming back to intercurrent illnesses, the patient has to be told to avoid any intercurrent illness, tuberculosis. He has to be told diabetics are more prone to get tuberculosis. Therefore, they have to wear mask whenever they find a patient who is coughing. HIV, so they have to use a appropriate sexual HIV appropriate behavior so that you don't end up into an HIV. Then COVID counseling. All patient needs to be told that maximum chances of death are there if you develop COVID. From day one, we need to tell them the role of surface disinfectant, physical distancing, and masking. Now, coming back to today, if my patient is going for a COVID vaccination, they need to be told about allergy, that they need to be told that with vaccination, their underlying diabetic inflammation can worsen. They need to be told about the tendency for thrombosis. Before I come back to the question of the day, I'm going to show you, because you could not see the slides due to some factor. So we have covered lifestyle consultation, carbohydrate less than 50%, protein 15%, fats less than 30%, lifestyle modification, specifically smoking, multifactorial risk factor, role of aspirin, pregnancy, diet control, aspirin if the risk is more than 10%, statins if the LDL is high, colchicine if the CRP is more than 1. Remember the formula of 80, the formula of 3, and the formula of 1500 and 500. This slide, everybody should do a print screen immediately. Men with diabetes, erectile dysfunction counseling, driving counseling, less than 70 blood sugar, and then hypoglycemia with exercise should be less than 90. And then new onset diabetes with COVID, physical activity, exercise-induced hypoglycemia, self-monitoring, behavioral lifestyle intervention, vaccination, oral antidiabetic agents, some supplements to be used, tuberculosis and diabetes, HIV and diabetes, and COVID counseling and COVID vaccination. Now, before I go to the question of the day, I want to show you some more slides. And these slides are, if a patient develops these findings after COVID-19 vaccination, be careful. So after you have given the vaccine, if the patient develops angioneurotic edema after 6 hours, nothing to worry. But if this angioneurotic edema occurs in the first 15 minutes, shoot adrenaline. The patient may develop a vaccine-induced rash on second day, nothing to worry. Urticaria, second day, nothing to worry. Diabetic patients may develop type 4 cell-mediated reactions if the vaccine is given, because on day one, patient will go for a vaccination also. On the very first day, you will say, take an appointment and take a vaccine. Specifically, if you are 45 plus, they may develop these types of cell-mediated reactions on their arm. This is cell-mediated reactions on the arms, on the leg, on the arm. This is from the literature showing different types of reactions. Diabetics, if you give them vaccine, they may precipitate underlying allergy. One female developed seizures. Patient may develop accelerated hypertension. Diabetes may get worsened after vaccine. Seizure may get precipitated. This is a patient who may develop high D-dimer. This is a patient who may develop ventricular tachycardia. Patient may develop atrial fibrillation, rheumatoid arthritis precipitation. The patient may have precipitation of idiopathic thrombocytopenic purpura. Now, these are the patients, precipitation of allergy, precipitation of herpes zoster, Bell's palsy, transverse myelitis, lymphadenitis, painful, episcleritis, left eye conjunctivitis. They may get myocardial infarction. They may get skin ITP. They may get brain hemorrhage. They may get post-vaccine systemic inflammation. This is a patient who developed systemic inflammation. So this is a inflammation in the leg. This is a inflammation or an allergic reaction in the back. So what I am trying to show is that if a patient comes to you on day one, when the patient has been diagnosed on day zero, now he comes to you on day one, you need to talk to him about counseling. Now, will you be able to finish the counseling on day one? The answer is no. Day one is equivalent to day chapter 2 of Bhagavad Gita. When Krishna explained to him everything, Arjun got confused. Now, once you have told him everything, now you tell him, come back again. I will discuss each point in great detail. From 3rd to 17th chapter, Krishna discusses whatever he has taught on day 2 in great detail. Daraya bhi, dhamkaya bhi, puchkara bhi, chinta mat kar main tere saath hoon. Therefore, on day 1, we will go for detailed analysis and counseling till my patient is confused, so that when he goes home, he actually starts getting the questions for us in our subsequent visits. Let's now come back to the question of the day. This is a question of the week. In order to avoid frequent fluctuations in blood glucose level, people with diabetes are advised to control the quantity, also the type of carbohydrate by consuming low glycemic index foods, which of the following foods have the lowest glycemic index? Remember, I gave you a hint in the very first slide. Pasta, chickpeas, potatoes, cornflakes, and white flour. 18 months old boy presented with 4 days of sudden onset severe watery diarrhea after 2 days of being non-specifically unwell. He was passing stool approximately 15 times per day. He had vomited for 1 day, but then this stopped. On examination, he was dehydrated. He requires aggressive fluid resuscitation. In addition to intravenous fluids or oral rehydration solution, what agent would improve the outcome? I think this is a straightforward question. Ascorbic acid, magnesium, thiamine, and zinc. Very straightforward question for you. Now, I call Ruchita to come back here and discuss further.
Yes, sir. Thank you so much, Dr. Agrawal, sir, for your guidelines on specifically after COVID symptoms, signs and symptoms of diabetic patients. Sir has very nicely highlighted American thoracic guidelines, then COVID diabetes he had highlighted, then exercise-induced hypoglycemia, vaccination-related things, oral anti-diabetic medicines, and other supplements. So thank you so much, sir, for very informative, one more informative session on diabetes, on diabetes essentials by Enerzal Zero. And thank you so much, the attendees.
There are some questions have come more. Which vaccine should I take? If you are very comorbid, then Covaxin, otherwise anyone. What to do if urticaria does not settle after a day or so? Continue H1 blocker, H2 blocker, and Montelukast. Should I get my patient as herpes labialis? Yes, give acyclovir. My patient has chicken pox. ये है विभा विभा जी मुझे आपका यू काइंडली कॉन्टेक्ट मी दिस पेशेंट डेवलप्ड चिकन पॉक्स द पेशेंट डेवलप्ड चिकन पॉक्स ऑन 10th डे आफ्टर द वैक्सीन कुड इट बी रिलेटेड 100% विभा जी आप मेरे को कॉन्टेक्ट करिए शुड सीआरपी डी डायमर बी डन बिफोर कोविड वैक्सीनेशन एटलीस्ट सीआरपी डू इट डोज ऑफ कॉल्चिसिन इज 0.5 मिलीग्राम sorry slides my mistake we will send the slides to FDC and all those people who are registered they may be able to send the slides to that
definitely sir.
So definitely and some people are saying voice is not clear so this person who has said that they have seen a patient of Vibha Mehta ji. Vibha, I will ask you to contact me and I would like to add that patient of chickenpox in my list of patients. That's all for today from my side. I rest my discussions.
Thank you so much, sir.
So we will be back next Sunday at 9 p.m. Keep watching. Diabetes Essentials 52 Weeks with Dr. K.K. Agarwal. Namaskar.
Thank you, sir.